moment. Jones! Barman! Kasprovic, the man to go, and Harmison has done it. Despair on the faces of the batsmen and joy for every England player on the field. Victory by two runs. England, Harmison has got the wicket. Kasprovic has done what he thought was right. And Jones has somehow managed to scramble across and dive and get both hands around the ball to end one of the most thrilling games of cricket there's ever been.
Who've they got striding in? Monty Panesar, number 11. What a monumental job he has to do alongside James Anderson. Monty Panesar. Solid defence. And away, England move into a lead of one. It's precarious. It's a jam shot down to third man from James Anderson. And again, runs here for Anderson. It squirts away. Lousy description, but it squirts away for four. Shakes. They've done it. They've waited out. They've realised it. Monty Panesar and Jimmy Anderson, 10 and 11. After a partnership of 69 deliveries, they've scored 19 runs. Jimmy Anderson, cool hand Luke, if you like. Monty Panesar will have loved the situation. England has survived. Australia have given them everything. Outstanding Australia.
So, after an excellent start by the Australians, they were 47 for no wicket. Michael Vaughan called on Freddie Flintoff in the 13th over. He was on a hat-trick, of course, after his first innings effort. He didn't get it, but...
Goal, he's got him! Freddie Flintoff! The man! Three wickets in four balls. But the breakthrough, that'll get him going.
That has got him going. And it also means that a right-hander will come in now. Ricky Ponting, the skipper, coming in at number three. But Flintoff has done it. He batted magnificently. Now, bad shoulder and all. Got the leg cutter. And it's got the inside edge of the bat. It jumped a little bit on Langer and then down onto the stumps. Beautifully bowled. 47 for one. In the 13th over.
Ricky Ponting on strike.
Oh, that's so close! And it's not out.
Oh, I say. Flintoff has changed the whole feeling of the occasion. Outside the line again. Ball, that won't be a problem as far as Flintoff's concerned.
Beauty! Yes! Magnificent cricket from this man. Really,
Headingley, he set the place alight. He's knocked the game on its head. Fantastic.
Big leg cutter, big outside edge, and a fast nick. What an over.
The events of this day beg a belief, as they did at Lord's in the World Cup final. Field slightly adjusts, Pat Cummins switches to bowl round the wicket, targeting body or stumps, one or t'other. It's body. Here's the single. Yes, England have tied the match. England have tied the match. And Stokes has the strike.
Jack Leach, you are my hero. The greatest one of all time.
Here we go then, the scores are level.
Yes!
For Headingley, 1981, Reid Headingley, 2019. One of, if not the greatest, Test match innings ever played has just seen England a victory in the highest run chase in their history. Having played the first Test match way back in 1877, England triumph here against the odds. A last wicket partnership that we'll never forget. 76 runs in it, of which Jack Leach made just a single. Ben Stokes is the hero of the land.
What a remarkable cricketer. Tim Payne's just consoled Nathan Lyon at backward point. The LBW, the run-out chance. But don't take anything away from that chap. Jack Leach also. What an atmosphere, what a series we have.
We've done so much for the game of cricket here today. As Test matches are threatened by all around them, so even that Australian will wake up tomorrow and surely understand that what Stokes has achieved is so special, so unique. It can inspire every young person in the country.
He bowled it perfectly.
Just watch this, just watch it. He changed his grip very late, bowled it like a little leg cutter, and he's gone over the top of it. That is superb bowling.
Could be tight. Yes, it is tight. Flintoff, the man. This is a massive moment. Ponting has a history of run-outs in the Ashes, and he might be gone.
Sure not. It's a direct hit, they're always close. As that man, Andrew Flintoff. I think Ponting's a bit behind, and it's out. Unbelievable. Oh, man, you've got a feel for it. Such a wonderful drop too. Not believe.
What different reactions. Look at the crowd reaction. Look at Ponting's reaction. He doesn't want to go off. His head goes down. He can't believe what he's done. You can't keep that man out of the game. He's been slow in the field. He's been hurting. He's been bruised. But when he needed to hit, knocked them over. England knew straight away. What a massive moment in this game. The Australian captain has been run out for 66.
Just in shock, Mass. I'm in shock. Massey hit it and called. Ricky Ponting just trusted the call. As soon gives a hitch, you know it's close. Freddie Newton's out too. I just can't believe it's going on. Yeah, well, maybe. Look, Ricky Ponting's backing up there. He sets off. Ricky Ponting had a quick look, but I think it was Andrew Flintoff. That's why Mike Hussey called.
It's not very good if they're all out by lunge. Oh, there you are. Line and length. It's as simple as that, isn't it? That didn't do very much, the ball, but it was a perfect line, perfect length, round off stump, in that corridor of uncertainty that creates doubt and problems for every batsman that's ever lived. And Rogers, the guy who's been scoring heavily, watch this. Ball, there you are, thank you very much. Soon as the ball dissipates, they've had it. They can't play the moving ball, it just does a little bit. Well, ball Stuart Broad, England on fire. Australia, absolutely miserable.
Well, it's the toss playing out, there's no doubt about it. England bowled well in the last Test match, and Broad is opening over. 2 wickets down already, Australia, can you believe it?
Catch, there you are, simple as that. They just cannot play against the moving ball. And this is just a little bit of movement. It is unbelievable how bad they are when the ball just moves a bit. You saw at Cardiff, you saw at Edgbaston. They were great on a flat pitch at Lord's. Oh, out! Oh, what a catch! What a brilliant catch! England on fire! The Ashes have just about won this morning. What a corker that was!
Big edge from Burgess. Stokes. At a fifth slip, he was Superman. The way that right arm was out. Have a go at this. Wow, that is a catch. That's brilliant stuff.
Whoa, if you've paid your money this morning to watch England, you're an England supporter. Broad's got 4 wickets for 6 runs. Bulger's gone for 1. Australia 21 for 5. Keep them coming in.
A 5-wicket haul in just 19 balls. That equals the fastest 5-wicket haul ever in the history of the game. Only the Australian Ernie Toshack back in 1947 can match that from Broad.
Good grab too from Alistair Cook.
Quite brilliant from England. The catch in, the bowling of Broad. Tested Australia's techniques. They've been pathetic.
And that's another one. And it's the same kind of dismissal that's characterised the whole of this appalling Australian batting performance. Just a poke outside off stump, no footwork, and another very good catch.
Stark, who played pretty well at Edgbaston, particularly in the second innings, falls to just a hint of a way swing. There isn't a lot of movement in that particular ball. There has been plenty of movement out there, and England have caught magnificently.
Oh, can you believe it? Complete repeat performance. Johnson this time just fiddling outside off stump. Actually, that was an excellent ball from Stuart Broad, and these are his best figures. 7 for 11 for Stuart Broad.
Well, we're now at the stage where we have a performance from Broad that's going to be talked about forever, rated alongside anything that's happened.
Catch. Simple as that. And eventually, Stuart Broad has got a rich reward. He deserves it, absolutely deserves it, for all the other wickets he got early on against the top-class batsmen. To get tail ender out, Lyon, nothing special there, but for him, it's been a special day.
Oh, it works too! 5 for Andrew Flintoff, a glorious moment. A brilliant moment. 1 for the nation, the saver. It's the honours board for Freddie.
Well, he hit the right length once again. He'd been trying desperately to York Siddle, but on that occasion, he produced the perfect delivery to give him 5. Just coming down the hill.
It's almost as if this is a goodbye. There's still a wicket to take if England are to win this match. But Flintoff and the faithful here at Lord's are sharing a special moment.
fabulous cricketer, fabulous energy, fabulous personality. Certainly his last test match at Lord's. That's 388 for nine.
Have a look, direct hits usually mean trouble. Now then, watch this. In he comes. Oh, he's struggling. He's out. Gone by a distance.
What a... Well, can you believe it? Ponting at full tilt. Look at him reaching for the line there. No dive. Here it comes. The Australian captain has to go. Run out. Direct hit by England's 12th man. He's made a name for himself overnight. Ponting having words with some of the England team. I don't know what about. He can just go and take his pads off and have a cup of tea.
It's a terrific piece of fielding. The captain's gone for Australia. Correct.